No! Hello, I'm Troy the Scooter Boy, and welcome to the Mint Tips Christmas Special. The only Christmas special on the internet. If you're gonna grind a curb, a ledge, a curb thing, or anything really on a scooter, you're going to need wax. Now, there's gonna be at least one of you ding-dongs in the comments saying, "You can grind without wax, Troy!" And you are what we in the industry would refer to as a... That being said, skate wax is super expensive. I mean, look at this cheese. But, if you've ever seen me at the skate park, I will always have skate wax. How? I'll show you! Merry Christmas, Troy. But Troy, what did all that have to do with skate wax? Well, I'll tell you, my chump. Here's the secret that skate companies don't want you to know. It's just wax. I've used skate wax, homemade skate wax, and candle wax, and felt absolutely no difference between any of them. So, for you chumps who don't get much pocket money, I'd recommend using a cheap, chunky candle. Because at the end of the day, wax is wax. It's all the same cheese! Genius! In order to whip catch, what's this now? Three out of ten, mate. Oh! Father Christmas, thanks for stopping by.
Ho, 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 no problem, Troy. So what do you want for Christmas, my boy?
Not this, that's for sure. Anyway, look, you, don't your gnomes need you at the North Pole or something, okay? Right, off you go. He's going now, goodbye, thank you for stopping by, thank you for the business, goodbye now. In order to whip catch, you have to rework the way your brain sees tail whips. A whip catch, as the name suggests, is when you perform a tail whip, but you catch the deck before it hits the ground. Start by jumping without the deck, then pull it up to catch your feet. Keep working on this and get used to the feeling of catching the deck. Then go to a skate park and get as much air off a ramp as you feel comfortable with. Whilst in the air, practice the technique again. Now start trying to flick the deck as you jump from it. This next part takes a bit of practice, but eventually, if you stick to it, you will start catching it. Your first catches will probably be from relatively slow whips. but this is because you're still used to the muscle memory timing of a normal tail whip you perform, given that much airtime. Eventually, once you can catch faster and faster whips, you can gradually lower the ramp height until you're ready to attempt them flat. My one tip for learning them flat is to lower your body as much as you can to give yourself the highest possible jump. Jump? I use two foot placement techniques to whip and catch these. The first is the more conventional flick with 2 feet, catch with 2 feet. The other you'll find easier to perform if you've watched Will's one-footed tail whip tutorial. I bring my right foot out away from my body, flick, catch, and then bring it back in so my left foot can place before landing. The only advantage to this technique, apart from looking pretty cool, is it can make whip to whip easier once you progress to it.
Right, I think that's more than enough of this episode.
Thanks for watching, I'll see you chumps around, and
Merry Christmas.
What do you mean that's not the end? You want me to what? You're as thick as a loaf of bread, mate, if you think you're gonna get me to
scootin' home for Christmas. I don't know why we're doing this. Well, I'm scootin' home for Christmas, yeah. Seriously, whose idea was this? And it's been too long. This video is too long. Sing this song. Waste everyone's time scooting on my scooter. We're scooting home for Christmas. Scooting home for Christmas. Brad?
Oi.
It's all the same cheese! Genius!